Amen. He's a new creature. Old things have what? Passed away. Behold, what? All things. I was going with Sister Hill. We've been going together for several months. Brother, we are very close because we almost were ready to get married. When I got saved, I wrote a letter and just explained to her exactly what happened to me. She was away for the summer break. She had gone to summer school, but she was out, I think, the 1st of August, and she had about a month, you know, at home. So this happened between the time that she left for the summer break and her return for the fall break was about the first week in September. So I wrote a letter, told her what had happened, and boy, I just filled it full of scriptures. Oh, it was full of scriptures. Amen. She, you know, she was a Baptist, had played the piano in her church, raised in the church every Sunday, and she had never been saved. Y'all know how they go. Yes. Never been saved. She had never felt the power of God one time. All she was, you know, we're used to is that you come, shake the preacher's hand, you put your name on the roll, and you make some kind of confession or whatever. And that was the thing that got you in church. So she wasn't saved, but when she got that letter, she read it, and that very night she had a vision. She had a dream, a vision, and she saw herself being lost. And she got stirred, and after returning a couple of weeks later, when she got back, her best friend brought her to church, and she received Christ. And a few weeks later, she received a baptism of the Holy Ghost. So God used that sister. This sister, by the way, was the sister of one of the few in our church that really fasted and prayed. And the other lady was my, you know, my stepmother, and she was over the prayer band. And but to show you that when you fast and pray and see God, God can use you in so many different ways. Amen. So that was the strength that Daniel had, because God used him not only to interpret the dream. I like that he interpreted, not only interpreted the dream of Nebuchadnezzar, which was the big image, you know, that huge image. The head was what? Gold. The shoulder and the breast was what? Silver. And the thighs were what? Brass. Legs were what? Iron. And the feet was clean iron. But that was a vision that the king could not even recall. Amen. So he put out the decree that if nobody, if none of the wise men, they asked the top wise men, amen, I need someone not only to interpret my dream, but to what? To recall the dream. And the top wise man said, King, you don't know what you're saying. Can't nobody recall the dream? You know, he knew that interpreting was impossible unless he could what? Recall it. But Daniel got together with the three Hebrew boys, and he said, brother, because the king has said if none of the wise men in this kingdom can interpret this dream or recall the dream, that means what? Everybody's head is going to be what? Cut off. Everybody's going to be killed, slain. So that put a lot of pressure on the wise men, and nobody had an answer. So they were all destined to be what? Killed. And guess what? Daniel, a little man, got his three friends together. They had been eating beans. Amen. So y'all think that eating this, y'all call it rabbit food. y'all criticize me. Pastor, you always talk about us eating rabbit food. See, 80% of your diet is supposed to be what? Raw. And after y'all saw the demonstration the other night, you ought to be convinced that unless your diet is alkaline, you're headed for trouble. You're really headed for trouble. So you really need to take heed. And I always say this, that I've been pastor here for about 80-some years. It seemed like that. But 35, all of 35, everybody. Okay, but here's the thing, that I've been a pastor here for a long time, and I have seen a whole lot of things. Boy, I have seen everything you can think of. I've gone through everything you can think of. And the only way I feel that I can, that I am sustained, and I still look pretty good.
Yes, amen.
I don't look too bad, do I? I don't look too beat down, do I? So you're still looking pretty good. But what happened is that we have already always pushed and taught and practiced fasting and prayer and eating right. Everybody always haven't adhered to that because sometimes people don't think that aspect of your walk with the Lord is that important, but it's very, very important. Otherwise, I wouldn't have been able to stand up out of depression. Because out north Tulsa, going through two or three different groups of folk, you know, we've had about three different generations of people that have passed through here. You know, hundreds and hundreds of them. And we were the first church to really was labeled as a word church out north. And a lot of the churches and ministries that's word churches now, and not only here, but that spring out of this church, they're all over the city. But many of them came to this church and got a lot of their training when the initiative. So we've gone through a whole lot of changes, but the thing that sustained me, and actually this church has never really experienced a, what you call a split. And when I tell other pastors, we've been here for 35 years, although we've had about three generations and we never had a split, they can't believe it. But it was because of the emphasis that we have always placed on what? Fasting and prayer, seeking God. Usually the people that were not in the flow of it, we fasted and prayed, we what? Fasted and prayed until we what? Prayed them out. And we ain't put nobody out, but we what? Prayed them out. How many know it's better to pray them out than put them out? People don't like to be put out. I let God put them out, right? All right, so that's been a real plus for us as a ministry, that we have taught people how to fast and pray. Now, there haven't been a whole lot of people that was with this ministry for many, 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 many years. But those that have go way back, I remember the first sister that our first founders, they were very good people, and they helped us to God. They got helped us to our prayer at this church. And in fact, they were one of the six that helped us to start this church. And they were very faithful, very committed. And I tried, man, she was a very powerful lady, very powerful. And everybody just loved her in this church. I mean, she was just really a wonderful person. And she retired in her 50s. And as a result of her retirement, she was able to do ministry full time. All right, but the problem was that she was a heavy smoker for many, many years. And after she retired, you know, I tried my best to show her where she needed to take, she needed to eat right. You know, every time I went to her house, she had this tea, and the tea, you know, maybe had a half a cup of sugar in a glass. She was really strong on sweetening, and she liked to cook. I'm not trying to scare nobody, but she liked to cook with pork. It doesn't work for everybody, because some people ain't gonna what, pay you no attention. I don't care how much I say, do not cook your brains in pork. Amen. If you want to live, stop eating white bread. And the sooner, the whiter the bread, the sooner you're dead. There's been some things that we've taught a long time, and people still ain't got it. Now, some people say, I'm gonna just eat like I want to eat. All right, so she was those kind, you know, I didn't hold it against her because I just loved her too much. I just also, you know, anything you want to eat, just, you know, just go on and bless it. And people think you can bless anything and it's okay. All right, well, you know, maybe it works for some people, amen, but it doesn't work for everybody. Is that right? Okay, but what happened was that the doctor said that whenever a sickness or disease starts from a habit that a person has many times before they got saved, way, way back, like smoking and things like that, that in order to turn things like that around after you get saved, you got to eat right. And then you got to not only eat right, when I say eat right, try to eat, you know, 60-80% of your diet raw. That means you're about a big salad, and it's easy to eat 60-80% raw because Brother Beauty and Sister Debbie, they went down to Porter and they brought me a big thing of peaches, fresh peaches. I mean, I could eat 4 or 5 of those at one time. This time of year, peaches, and you'd rather have, what? Ham hocks, I mean, whatever y'all like. Which is acid. I mean, most people are gonna have some meat and some what, macaroni and some what, cobbler and all this stuff. And most of that do not have any kind of nutritional value hardly at all because we cook all of the nutrition out of it. Is that right? But I can't understand people that don't like watermelon, cantaloupe, honeydew, peaches. What else do they have in the summertime that's really good? Strawberries. Well, that's easy. Bananas. I mean, you can do that real easy in the summertime. And then if you want to do your baked potato and your and some salmon or baked chicken in the evening time with a huge salad, I mean, that's about all you're going to have to do in order to get your diet. Now, if you are very more serious, you can get your juice up. And Sister Hill, you know, since you begin to do this water, the impurities is coming out of her system. She said, I'm going to start tomorrow on my juice that day. Because she's trying to get all of this poison and toxins out of her system. So, a juicer is excellent. A juicer. But if I suggested that to half of you, you need to get you a juicer. So a juicer, that means that everything that comes out of that is going to be alkaline. And that's good. Now, do you know what can happen in 30 days if you just only juice alone? I mean, everything in your system, amen, probably would just what, clear up. It would just clear up. So juicing is good. So what I tried to get over all of these years is that it's important because the doctor was saying about this member, he said that if she had just went to a good diet, put all this sugar and all this bread and all this stuff that people just like to eat, a whole lot of, amen, she didn't drink water. You know, but people make big, huge mistakes. They don't drink water. And then they eat everything except what? Fruits and vegetables. Sometimes people say, I'm allergic to fruits and I can't eat fruits and vegetables. I'm allergic. Anybody allergic? Okay, if you're allergic, that means that what? You're on the acidic side. As soon as you can get from acidic to alkaline, amen, you'll find out those allergies are gone. Okay, so but the doctor said that even when you get to a good diet, if you have 20 years you've been smoking and doing some wearing your body down and destroying your body, he said when you get saved, when you stop doing that, you got to eat right, and then you have to try to what, supplement your diet, because that means that your body got to what, it's got to have more than just the bare necessities. The bare necessities to sustain it in order to go back and repair. You understand what I'm saying? Go back and repair. All of the damage has been done all these years. You got to eat right over here after you get on the right side. You got to eat right, right? Have the right water and all that kind of stuff. And then you have to have what? Supplements. The average person, you can't even sell them on supplements. People say, I'm saved. I believe God. I don't need nothing. I don't need nothing but the word. And sometimes, you know, the strangest thing that happened, but this sister, that was her only area that she really didn't understand how your diet really